A very good afternoon to you guys. Today we're gonna look at pumps. Okay. Now, what is a pump? A pump is a device used for lifting water and gases using atmospheric pressure. It is a device used for lifting water and gases using atmospheric pressure. That is a pump. Okay, that's the basic definition of a pump. So according to your syllabus, we are going to look at the blade pump and the bicycle pump. So I'll start with the blade pump. Now, a blade pump looks like this. Okay, this is the handle. And there's a dot here at the middle. We continue like this, and here it's something like this. There's another dot here. So here we have an arrow that's pointing this side. Okay, so here the handle is up. Handle up. Then the piston valve is closed. Piston valve closed. Okay. Then the foot valve is open. Food valve open. So water enters the food valve. Water enters the food valve. Okay. During what is known as an upstroke. That's the reason why you can see we have an arrow that is going up. Right? Then we now want to look at the downstroke. The downstroke is very similar to the upstroke. This is now a downstroke. Okay, it continues. Okay, so during the downstroke, the foot valve is closed. As you can see, the foot valve is closed and the handle is down. Handle down. Okay. And this is known as the downstroke. Right. So basically that's a blow pump. So what it does is it gives a steady supply of water for small communities. So it can lift water to a height of about 10 meters and the pump handle is connected to a piston which moves in a cylinder that is fixed below the water level in a well. So valves are present, one at the bottom of the cylinder and another on the piston, as we have seen per diagram around the drawer. So these valves, they only open upwards, okay? So in a downstroke, the valve on the piston opens due to an increase in pressure in the space between the piston valve and the cylinder valve, which is closed to the space above the valve. And during the upstroke, the piston valve closes, trapping water in the pump and raising the main cylinder. So pressure inside the space between the piston valve and the cylinder valve falls, forcing more water into the space. Okay. So basically, this is how the blow pump operates. Okay. Now we need to look at what is known as a bicycle pump. Now, let me draw the bicycle pump first. Okay, so this one is the sucking rod. Okay, and this one is the plunger. And we have an outer casing. This one. Which is called the well casing. the riding valve. Okay, and we have these ones are called inlets. Okay, and we have what are called standing valve. These ones. Okay, so this is a bicycle pump. Okay, so a bicycle pump is made up of a piston moving within a cylinder. So the cylinder is a hole at the end, and the piston is a leather washer, which acts as a valve. So when a piston is pulled out, pressure inside the cylinder is reduced and the tire valve closes. Atmospheric pressure or atmospheric force forces air in around the edges of the washer into the cylinder. So when the piston is pushed inwards, the air in the cylinder is now compressed. That leather washer gives an airtight heat against the wall of the cylinder, and the air is pushed out into the tire valve. So as air is added to the tire, it becomes increasingly difficult to pump in more air due to increase in pressure in the tires. Okay? So basically, this is how this thing works, the bicycle pump. Okay. Now we need to look at a siphon. Now, what is a siphon? A siphon is a way of emptying a liquid from a container which has no outlet. So by saying a container which has no outlet, so empty a liquid in container like this. This container has no outlet, I not tape or whatever that is connected to it. Okay? So for the siphon to work, the container must be full. That's the first thing. For the siphon to work, then it also works under the influence of gravity. Okay. So I will draw a diagram to illustrate how a siphon looks like. So this is a siphon. So the liquid will be collected. The liquid would then be moved into this lower container. That's the reason why I was saying the siphon must be full. Okay? So we now want to move to hydraulic system. Okay, we now want to move to what are known as hydraulic systems. Now, this makes use of three properties of liquids. Liquids can pass pressure applied to them in all directions. Liquids cannot be compressed, and liquids can flow. So hydraulic systems, we're now looking at systems like motor car braking systems, okay? So hydraulic system, they make use of three properties of liquid. Okay. The first thing is liquids can pass pressure. Liquids can pass pressure applied to them in all directions. Pressure applied to them in all direction. Okay, liquids cannot be compressed. That's another property. Liquids cannot be compressed. That's the other property. And liquids can flow. So let us look at the motor car braking system. Now, a motor car braking system works like this. Pressure on the brake pedal causes the piston in the master cylinder to compress the brake fluid. Okay? This is the first thing that happens. So this pressure is passed on equally to the larger piston in the wheel cylinder. So the force of friction stops the car. The brake pedal is the lever, and the brake fluid is used because it is non-corrosive. Okay,
So basically, this is how the braking system of a car works. Now, let us look at applications of hydraulic systems. Applications. Of hydraulic system. They are used in front end loaders and tippers. Automatic tipper trucks. ETC. So this marks the end of our lecture. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to let me know at 0784002002. Goodbye. And also don't forget to subscribe and like on my YouTube channel.